year 1066 is possibly the most important date in English history. In 1066, William the Conqueror defeated the English King Harold at the Battle of Hastings. It was fought in these fields behind me, near the city of Hastings. The importance is that with the arrival of William, the language, the culture, and the literature of England changed forever. William, now known as William the Conqueror, had a church built on this site. This stone supposedly marks the exact spot where the English King Harold died. William moved to London, where he had himself crowned king in Westminster Abbey. Of course, his knights, their ladies, their servants, the entire court went with him, and Old French became the language of the court, the language of the government, the law, all the aristocratic society. Only the peasants, the conquered peasants, still spoke the Anglo-Saxon Old English. However, within 300 years of the Norman conquest, English had emerged as the predominant language. How did that happen? How did the language of the losers win out over the language of the conquerors? Well, the way it happened is that William granted land grants to the knights who had served him in battle. They moved with their families and a few household servants out to their new estates all across England. When they got there, of course, what language were the peasants who worked the land speaking? What language were the clergymen speaking? The craftsmen, even their household servants who came with the estate, were all speaking English. The knights pretty well had to learn English in order to survive. Their children naturally learned English because they heard it as they were growing up. Within 300 years, English is again the dominant language in England, but this time it's a very different language. It's the language of Chaucer. I've asked you to look at and to listen to a sample of the Old English language, and then to look at and listen to a sample of Chaucer's Middle English, and to see the differences in the two. The next great invention was Caxton's printing press here in England, and the setting down of the English language into print. Modern English was born.